Good evening and welcome everyone to St. Anne's Catholic Church in Washington, D.C. I'm Monsignor Watkins, pastor of St. Anne's, and it is a special honor for me to welcome our guest artist this evening, Eric Plutz from Princeton University, who plays tonight our third live-streamed organ concert here at St. Anne's as we celebrate our 150th parish anniversary year. Mr. Plutz will be playing on our 1999 Létourneau organ, and we are delighted that he's with us tonight to perform Vierne's Fifth Symphony. An audience is not a possibility for us during these challenging times, but we are certain that his playing, as well as the excitement, sound, and colors of this organ, will not be lost on you. We hope you can view our upcoming events here at our parish on our website, stanndc.org, stanndc.org. Our past recitals have been huge success, thanks in large measure to our director of music here at St. Anne's, Mr. Robert Bright, and we thank him for planning this wonderful recital tonight. And now, here's Eric Plutz to speak to us about the great Fifth Symphony by Louis Vierne. Thank you, Eric, for joining us tonight.
Thank you. I would like to add my thanks to you for tuning in this evening as well. It is a pleasure to celebrate Louis Vierne's sesquicentennial with you this evening. I'd like to give you a few things to listen for on this evening's program of the Organ Symphony No. 5 in A minor. Written in 1924, Vierne's Fifth Symphony is his longest and one of his cyclic symphonies. That means that the symphony contains two themes upon which each of its movements is based. This symphony, however, represents his style's zenith and the peak of the cyclic form. The two themes on which the entire work is built are presented right at the beginning of the first movement. The first descends and is without accidentals. The second ascends and is chromatic. These two pillars that support the symphony are sometimes modified and changed. For example, one might be played upside down, and the other might be changed from minor to major. Due to its complexity and heavy chromaticism, the work was performed twice at its premiere to help the audience grasp it. More than any other composition by Vierne, one can hear the influence of Richard Wagner here. And like Wagner, due to the chromatic character of one of Vierne's themes, some parts of this symphony achieve an almost atonal quality. The Fifth Symphony is the only symphony of Vierne to receive a French review during Vierne's lifetime, that of Jean Huret, who wrote these words: "I promise Vierne to curse him bitterly if with such talent he should again write so perfect a work, to express such pain and anguish in the course of 47 pages of very beautiful music." The reviewer aptly sums up the essence of the work, calling it the victory of joy over pain. And now, without any further delay, Vierne's Fifth Symphony.
Absolutely magnificent, Eric. Thank you so much. One gains from the musical themes, as you enunciated earlier before your performance, from notes of pain and anguish, ultimately to victory. And isn't that an inspiring theme for all of us during these difficult times? And in particular, as we focus our charity this evening for our brothers and sisters who are suffering from the devastating fires in the state of California. So we are designating our charity through your contributions this evening to assist them in their time of need. And as you see now across your screen, you have three options if you'd like to make a tax-deductible contribution to help us with this charity to assist so many in need in California right now with the relief effort and the wildfires there. A one-time or recurring donation at stanndc.org/music. Or if you're a parishioner here at St. Anne's, you can use your Faith Direct at standdc.org/give and write in the notes section for California. Or you can Venmo at Natalie J. Plum and write California in the for section. We thank you for support for this concert, and we want to thank Eric Plutz once again for a magnificent rendition of Louis Vierne's Fifth Symphony. Save the date now for our next recital here at St. Anne's in Washington, D.C. on October the 16th at 7:30 p.m. with Jay Parata, a local and fantastic organist artist who will join us then. We thank you for being with us tonight. God bless you. And Eric, any last minute off-the-cuff remarks about your experience of this Létourneau organ and tonight's concert?
All I can say, it's been a pleasure to be here and to play this music that means so much to me on an instrument that brings it to life in a truly wonderful way. Thank you very much for tuning in.